Some people I know right back at home.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
Yes. But do you know, it's like God selected beautiful people are in this place. Handsome people, beautiful. I'm telling you, right, look at this young man. Look at how handsome he is. Hallelujah. Look at your mama here, beautiful. And right down there, every time and ever you are a wonderful creature of God. Say you are beautiful.
You are a wonderful creature of God.
I really mean it. Tell somebody you are beautiful. I want to see you talk to somebody. I'm not kidding here. I'm serious about it. Yes. Say you are wonderfully and fearfully made. When you smile, it's like heaven is coming down. The ghost of love and God bless you.
Hey.
Like selected, it's like only handsome people believe. Hallelujah. God likes good things also. Amen. And I see his handiwork here. And I thank God. Amen.
Amen.
My wife asked me to greet you. My children asked me to greet you. I'm married to one of the most beautiful women. Hallelujah. Good. Let me tell you a bit about the ministry back at home and then I will preach, okay? We are in Boya. I'm sure many of you know, because I was here last year, I'm sure some of you should know. I am in Boya. God called me to... God called me for the revival of Cameroon and the nations.
Dieu m'a appelé pour le réveil du Cameroun et des nations.
Actually, I was in Bible school with Pastor Michel. We were classmates in Bible school.
J'étais à l'école publique avec le pasteur Michel. Nous étions les camarades de classe.
And thank God for what he did in our lives during that 3 years of training in the Bible school.
Nous bénissons le Seigneur pour ce qu'il a fait dans nos vies pendant ces 3 ans d'études.
So God called me and separated me for the revival of Cameroon.
Dieu m'a appelé et m'a séparé pour le réveil du Cameroun.
I am in the city of Boya, in the southwest province in Cameroon.
Je suis à Boya, dans le sud-ouest.
We are running a radio station.
Nous gérons une radio.
Yeah, no, Revival Gospel Radio.
On appelle ça la radio du réveil.
That's right. We have a church. We have 3 churches in the city of Boya.
Nous avons 3 églises à Boya.
And we call it Revival Chapels.
Et on appelle ça les chapelles du réveil.
We have a Bible school now.
On a une école biblique maintenant.
We call it Revival Institute of Ministerial Arts.
On appelle ça l'Institut biblique du réveil. De l'art du réveil.
Amen. By the grace of God, the radio is touching and transforming lives.
Par la grâce de Dieu, la radio est en train de toucher et de transformer les vies.
Last year, we had 360,000 telephone calls.
L'année passée, on a eu 360,000 coups de téléphone.
That's 360,000 telephone calls.
360,000 coups de téléphone.
From Boya, we are reaching Douala, we are reaching Edea.
In Boya, on atteint Douala, Edea.
Close to Yaoundé.
Et à côté de Yaoundé.
Close to Bafoussam.
À côté
that's
de
right
aussi.
Up to Batie Hill.
Jusqu'à Batie.
And Kounsamba.
Et Kounsamba aussi.
Part of Koumba.
Et une partie de Koumba.
Many people are believing.
Beaucoup de gens sont en train
Amen.
De croire.
Amen. The Secretary General of Witch Doctors in the Southwest Province gave his life to Jesus Christ.
Le secrétaire général de la sorcellerie dans le sud-ouest a donné sa vie à Jésus.
Can you say amen? Yes, Secretary General of Witch Doctors.
Le secrétaire général de la
sorcellerie. Surrender to Jesus Christ. And he surrendered all his fetishes, we burn them. Hallelujah.
Amen.
And we have trained him in and laboratory technician. He is now a laboratory technician.
Et on l'a formé pour le laboratoire et maintenant il est technicien du laboratoire.
Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
There are many, many miracles God is doing back at home through the radio.
De miracles Dieu est en train de faire au pays à travers la
People are baptized in their homes.
Les gens sont baptisés dans leur maison.
In the Holy Spirit. Through the radio.
À travers la radio.
Demons leave people.
Les démons libèrent les gens.
From their home.
Dans leur maison.
Through the radio.
À travers la radio.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
That is what God is doing.
C'est ce que Dieu fait.
Our vision.
Notre vision.
Is to reach 1 million people every day with the gospel of Jesus Christ.
C'est d'atteindre 1 million de personnes chaque jour avec la radio.
I'm saying this so that you pray with us.
J'ai dit ceci pour que vous priez avec nous.
And stand with us.
Et vous priez avec nous.
Amen.
Amen.
If you have people at home, pray for the radio. Who knows through the radio they can believe.
Si vous avez des gens au pays, priez pour la radio. À travers la radio, ils peuvent croire.
Amen.
Amen.
Even if you're not from Cameroon, pray because very soon the radio will be reaching the whole of Africa and even here in the US.
Même si tu n'es pas au Cameroun, prie parce que bientôt la radio va atteindre toute l'Afrique.
Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
So stand with us, pray with us.
Alors, tiens-toi avec nous,
and we will pray with you also.
Et nous allons aussi prier avec
that is that.
Amen.
Amen. I'm going to sing one little song and then I preach.
Un chant avant de prier.
And the power of God will knock this place again a second time.
Yeah.
I said the power of God will knock this place a second time.
Yeah.
Amen.
Amen.
I know what I'm talking about. The power of God will come down.
La puissance de Dieu va descendre.
Amen.
Amen.
And your testimony will be sealed.
Et ton Amen. Témoignage sera scellé.
Amen.
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 You may not know the song, just listen while I sing.
Tu ne vas connaître le chant, tu écoutes pendant que je chante.
It's about the Holy Spirit.
Ça concerne le Saint-Esprit.
Holy Spirit, may you reign, may you reign. Holy Spirit, may you reign, may you reign. Yesterday you reign in my life. Amen. Today come and reign, reign forevermore. Yesterday you reign in my life. Today come and reign, reign forevermore. Holy Spirit, may you reign, Holy Spirit. May you reign, yesterday you reign in my life, today come and reign, reign forevermore, yesterday you reign in my life, today come and reign, reign forevermore, yesterday you reign, you reign. Your presence here. Holy Spirit, we know you are the senior pastor of this church. Holy Spirit, we pray, rain this morning. Speak this morning. Do your work this morning. Holy Ghost, take over. It is not about me. It's not about Pastor Michel. It's not about any of us. It is about you, oh God.
Amen.
Amen.
Therefore, Father, shift me from the center. Shift me from the center, oh God. Let them not hear me. Let them hear you. Let them not see me. Let them see you. Father, anoint me. Touch me. Touch my lips, oh God. Speak through me, Lord. Break every yoke in every life. Deliver every individual here, oh God. Speak, Lord. Speak, Father. Speak to me, Lord. Speak to somebody, Lord. In the name of Jesus. In the name of Jesus. And the people of God shout, Amen. And they shout a big Amen. Amen. God bless you. You may be seated. I have a message God has laid on my heart for you this morning.
J'ai un message que Dieu a placé sur mon corps ce matin.
And it is titled The Race of Faith.
Ce titre quoi est?
The Race of Faith.
La course de la foi.
Or The March of Faith.
Ou le match de la foi.
The Race of Faith.
La course de la foi.
Or The March of Faith.
Ou le match de la foi.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
I come to tell you this morning, my dear brothers and sisters, we are running a race. But the good thing about this race is that we are running like winners. You have won. And you are still running. You have won already. There is a crown prepared for you. There is a crown prepared for you. Waiting for you. You have been selected. You have been chosen. You have been made a winner. Just run and get your crown. Hallelujah. Just run and get your crown. We are running a race of faith. Running like winners. Running to get a crown. That was prepared for you right from the foundation of the earth. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
We are not fighting for victory.
Nous ne combattons pas pour la victoire.
We are fighting from the victory.
Nous combattons de la victoire.
Of the cross.
De la croix.
Now listen.
Écoutez.
When I arrived here in February,
quand je suis arrivé ici en février,
I was shocked.
J'ai été choqué.
By news.
Par la nouvelle.
By what is happening in the United States of America.
Par ce qui se passe ici aux États-Unis.
The first greeting that I had.
La première salutation que j'ai eue.
I was watching news on CNN.
J'étais en train de suivre les informations.
They said a man in one of the states, I've forgotten, took a gun, shot his wife, shot his two children, and killed himself because he lost his job. Did you hear that?
Un homme a pris le fusil, tué sa femme, tué ses enfants, et se tué parce qu'il a perdu son emploi.
Did you hear that?
Vous avez suivi.
I was shocked.
J'ai été choqué.
As if that were not enough.
Comme si ça ne suffisait pas.
They say another young man in Alabama took a gun and went on a shooting spree and shot people around.
Un autre gars à Alabama a pris le fusil et allé tuer les gens.
Did you hear that?
Est-ce que vous avez
yes. Shocking news. As if that were not enough.
Comme ça ne suffit pas.
I heard the president saying in the month of February.
J'ai écouté le président dire au mois de février.
1,650,000 people lost their jobs in the U.S.
1,060,000 personnes ont perdu. 1,650,000 personnes ont perdu leur emploi aux États-Unis.
As if that was not enough.
Comme ça ne suffit pas.
They said 16 million have lost their jobs in the U.S.
On dit 16 millions ont perdu leur emploi aux États-Unis.
Every time I want to watch news, I get but bad news.
Chaque fois que je veux suivre les informations, je reçois des
foreclosures. There are foreclosures, houses.
Les maisons Les maisons aux enchères.
What is happening?
J'ai dit qu'est-ce qui se passe?
In this big nation.
Dans cette grande nation.
This nation that is ruling the world.
Cette nation qui roule le monde.
What, Lord, why did you bring me here now?
Seigneur, pourquoi m'as-tu amené ici maintenant?
Ah, the bills are increasing.
Les factures sont en train d'augmenter.
Oh, the mortgages are pressing hard on people.
Les mortgages sont en train de presser.
It's like there is darkness everywhere.
C'est comme s'il y a les ténèbres partout.
God, what is happening?
Seigneur, qu'est-ce qui se passe?
Wow, what is happening?
Qu'est-ce qui se passe?
Each time I want to watch news.
Chaque fois que je veux suivre les
informations,
il y a une mauvaise nouvelle.
America.
America.
America wonder.
America wonder.
God, what is happening?
Seigneur, qu'est-ce qui se
passe? So I went back to God and said, Lord, what is that, what is happening?
Je suis rentré au Seigneur, demandé au Seigneur qu'est-ce qui se passe.
And the Lord told me to bring you good news. I bring you good news this morning. Can you say amen, somebody?
Amen.
Say amen. I bring you good news this morning. No matter the bad news in the air, there is good news. Hallelujah. There is good news. And God told me, the importance of light can only be felt when there is darkness.
L'importance de la lumière peut être sentie seulement quand il y a les ténèbres.
I want to let you know
that
this is the best time for you to live.
Que ça, c'est le meilleur temps pour toi de vivre.
This is the best time for you to live.
Yeah.
This is the best time for me to come to the U.S.
Yeah.
Are you hearing me, somebody?
Yeah.
Are you hearing me?
Yeah.
This is the best time for this church.
Ça, c'est le meilleur moment pour cette église.
This is the best time for Americans.
Ça, c'est le meilleur moment pour les Américains.
God allowed crisis to come.
Dieu a laissé les crises venir.
So that they will seek for God.
Pour qu'ils cherchent Dieu.
God allowed 9/11 to come.
Dieu a permis le 11 novembre.
You know 9/11?
Pour qu'ils cherchent Dieu.
9 September, right?
Septembre 9.
They're hooked to money. People have been seeking money, worshiping money,
adorant l'argent.
And God said, I will touch that one so that you seek for me.
Et Dieu a dit que je veux toucher afin que vous me cherchiez.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
I was in Florida.
J'étais en Floride.
And I was talking to one young lady.
Et je parlais à une jeune fille.
Whose father had an oil company, a refinery.
Une jeune fille que son père a une compagnie d'huile.
Refinery.
Raffinement. The raffinerie.
We have only one refinery in Cameroon that is owned by government. Here, somebody has his own. And the daughter was there for the seminar with me. And she told me, I've lived a good life. I've lived well.
J'ai vécu bien.
But something happened.
Mais quelque chose
she
passé.
Said, my father had to sell the company to another person.
Mon père devait vendre la compagnie
he
à une
actually sold the company to another person.
Il a vraiment vendu à une autre personne.
And the man made the conditions too bad for me to be there.
Et l'homme a vendu les conditions tellement mauvais pour moi pour être là-bas.
So I have to leave that company.
Alors je devais laisser cette compagnie.
I have no hope.
Je n'ai plus d'espoir.
And we talked about many things, talked about government.
Et nous avons parlé de beaucoup
and
de
I
choses.
Showed her Jesus Christ.
Même du gouvernement, et je lui ai montré Jésus-Christ.
I showed Jesus Christ who never failed.
J'ai montré Jésus qui n'est
and she accepted Jesus Christ.
Amen.
With tears in her eyes, she surrendered her life to Jesus
Amen.
Christ.
Amen. Elle a abandonné sa vie à Jésus.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
This is the time
ça, c'est le moment.
For you to shine. It is the time for God to be seen in our lives.
Amen.
Do you know that the Bible says, when there is a downcasting, you shall say there is an uprising?
No.
While others will be going down, you will be going upward.
Pendant que les autres vont descendre, toi tu vas monter.
Amen.
Amen.
When others will be going downward, you will be going upward.
Quand les autres vont descendre, toi tu vas monter.
It is in time like this.
C'est le moment comme ceci.
When others will say there is a famine, you will say there is abundance.
I'm
speaking to somebody here. I'm talking. Your neighbors will be saying that there is famine. You will say, come and eat in my house. Are you hearing me, brother? This time around,
À ce moment-ci,
God is going to make a distinction between those who believe him and those who don't believe him. God is going to make a show a difference between you who believe God and those who don't believe God. Hello. Hello. Don't think that things may get better. Things may even get worse for the whole country. But it will be good for you. Did you know that when Joseph was in Egypt, everybody was suffering and dying? But Joseph was giving food to people. Are you understanding what I'm saying, somebody? This is the time you will share food to somebody. Are you hearing me, somebody? Hold on, God. Hold on, God. Hold God. There's going to be a difference in your life. There is going to be a difference in your life. In the name of Jesus. In the name of Jesus. As we are on this march of faith. As we are running this race of faith, hold on, Jesus. There will be darkness everywhere, but you will be the light. I say you will be the light. I say you will be the light. I say you will be the light. People will complain of diseases. They will talk of cancer, but you will be the healer. Good news. I am the carrier of the good news. When people say they are going down, I will be going up. You will be going up. When they talk about crisis, I'll be talking of abundance. Do you know why? Because life without Christ is full of crisis. Life without Christ is full of crisis. Do you have Christ?
Yes.
Do you have Christ?
Yes.
Do you have Christ?
Yes.
You want me to speak my dialect?
Yes.
You want me to feel like an American? Do you have Christ? Say, yeah, I have Christ.
Yes.
Hallelujah.
Yes.
If you have Christ, therefore no crisis.
Yes.
Family without Christ is full of crisis.
La famille sans Christ est plein de crises.
Job without Christ is full of crisis. Job.
Le travail sans Christ est plein de crises.
A nation without Christ is full of crisis.
Une nation sans Christ est plein de crises.
But when Jesus comes in,
mais quand Jésus entre,
crisis go away. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. I come to encourage you this morning.
Je suis venu vous encourager ce
matin. Hold on, Christ. Hold Jesus. Hold Jesus.
Yes, Pastor.
Hold Jesus. Hallelujah. Do what?
Hold Jesus.
Do what?
Hold Jesus.
That is your hope. The dollar will fail you. America will fail you. Everything will fail you. But Jesus never fails. Jesus never fails. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
While running this race, call Jesus.
Pendant que nous faisons cette course, tenons Jésus.
Amen.
Amen.
Please don't play with your Christian life.
S'il vous plaît, ne jouez pas avec votre vie chrétienne.
Don't play, I beg you, with your Christian life.
Je vous en prie, ne jouez pas avec votre
vie. Are you hearing me?
Est-ce que vous m'écoutez?
If you have to absent from your job to come to church, do it.
Si tu dois manquer ton travail pour venir à l'église, fais-le.
Are you hearing me?
Est-ce que vous m'écoutez?
Come for Bible study, come for worship on Sunday.
Viens à l'étude biblique. Viens à l'église le dimanche.
You will see the difference.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
Look, I'm telling you from experience. I'm not just talking about experience.
Je parle de l'expérience. Je parle à partir de.
I said I'm going back to Cameroon.
Je vous dis que je rentre au Cameroun.
I will stay here.
Et nous je ne dois pas rester.
I will not stay here.
Je ne veux pas rester.
I will go back.
Je veux rentrer.
Cameroon is not up to America. You know that, not so.
Le Cameroun n'est pas comme l'Amérique, vous le savez.
It's in development. It's a third world. But to me, it's the first world.
Yes.
To me, Cameroon is the first world.
Yes.
Hallelujah. There is gold in Cameroon.
Yes.
There's everything in Cameroon.
Yes.
I will use that and affect the nations.
Yes.
But there are people in Cameroon
Regardez-moi, il dit, Pasteur Temi, comment tu le fais?
We can't even have food. We are going all over the world preaching the gospel.
Nous ne pouvons même pas avoir la nourriture, mais tu pars partout dans le monde prêcher.
Jesus never fails.
Amen.
Hallelujah. Amen. This is next month. That's May. I'm going to South Africa for a conference.
En mai, je serai en Afrique du Sud.
In June, I will be in London.
Juin, je serai en Londres.
In August, I'll be in Germany. September, I'll be coming back to America. And I will go back to the land of glory. Hallelujah. There are people who are saying it is bad, but to me it is good. To you it's going to be good, somebody. It's going to be excellent, somebody. Hallelujah. Alright, let me read the Bible and just, you know, talk about this race of faith.
Lire la Bible et vous parler de cette course de la foi.
Can we quickly go to the book of John chapter 10?
Allons dans le livre de Jean chapitre 10.
No, John chapter 20, please.
Jean 20.
John 20. Thank you.
Merci.
Are you in John chapter 20?
Yes.
Jean 20.
From verse 1 to 18.
De 1 à 18.
Are you there?
Amen.
All right. John chapter 20. John is in the New Testament. God bless you. All right. I will just read from you, okay? From verse 1 right down. And I will pick a few things from there.
Je vais lire à partir du verset.
And I will encourage you and
je
we'll close.
Prendre quelque chose pour vous encourager et nous allons clôturer.
Early in the morning on the first day of the week, while it was still dark, Mary Magdalene went to the tomb and saw that the stone had been removed from the entrance. So she came running to Simon Peter and the other disciples, and the one Jesus loved, and said, "They have taken the Lord out of the tomb, and we don't know where they have put him." So Peter and the other disciple started for the tomb. Both were running, but the other disciple outran Peter and reached the tomb first. Verse 5. He bent over and looked in at the strips of linen lying there, but he did not go in. Verse 6. Then Simon Peter, who was behind him, arrived and went into the tomb. He saw the strips of linen lying there, as well as the burial cloth that had been around Jesus' head. The cloth was folded up by itself, separate from the linen. Verse 8. Finally, the other disciple who had reached the tomb first also went inside. He saw and believed. They still did not understand from Scripture that Jesus had to rise from the dead. Then the disciple went back to their homes. But Mary... Somebody say, but Mary.
But Mary.
Say, but.
But.
Say, but.
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 Let's go ahead.
Continue.
What happened? But Mary stood outside the tomb crying. As she wept, she bent over to look into the tomb and saw two angels in white seated where Jesus' body had been, one at the head and the other at the foot. They asked her, "Woman, why are you crying?" They have taken my Lord away, she said, and I don't know where they have put him. At this, she turned around and saw Jesus standing there, but she did not realize that it was Jesus. "Woman," he said, "why are you crying? Who is it you are looking for?" Thinking he was the gardener, she said, "Sir, if you have carried him away, tell me where."